Good morning, students. Students, we have completed chapter number 1, 2, and 3, and that will be the portion of your first periodic test. So, in this week, we will do the revision of all these chapters. So, I am going to start chapter number 1 today. In this chapter, we will revise different terms used in this chapter. One by one. So let us start. Student, this is the chapter Nutrition in Living Organism Plants. And before starting it, I want to clear one thing. There are two terms, the similar terms. They are nutrients and nutrition. Nutrients, as you studied earlier, that they are the component present in our food items and they are essential for our growth and development. They are nutrients. And nutrition is a process in which food is obtained and utilized by our body, by all living organisms. This is the difference between nutrients and nutrition. So always remember it, nutrients are the components and nutrition is a process. So this is the chapter about nutrition in living organism plants. Friends, as you know that plants are autotroph because they can prepare their own food. They have chlorophyll in them, so they can prepare their own food. And animals which cannot prepare their food and they depend upon plants, they are known as heterotrophs. That means process of nutrition accordingly, it is classified into two groups, autotrophs and heterotrophs. There is a flow chart on your screen in which modes of nutrition is classified into autotrophic nutrition, example all green plants. And the second one is heterotrophic nutrition. Examples are animals, man, and non-green plants also. Because non-green plants means the plants which do not have chlorophyll in them and so they cannot prepare their food. So they are also heterotrophs. And again, heterotrophic nutrition is classified into three groups. The first one is saprotrophic nutrition. Second is parasitic nutrition and third is holozoic nutrition. We will study about all these type of nutrition in next. And now we will do the process of preparation of food in plants that is known as photosynthesis. Photosynthesis, well known to you now because you have studied in class 5, class 6 and now in class 7. It is the process by which plants prepare their food in the presence of sunlight using carbon dioxide and water. The equation of photosynthesis, that is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll, and the products are carbohydrate and oxygen. Now students, we will study about the raw materials for photosynthesis. As you know that the raw materials which are used in the process of photosynthesis are water, mineral, carbon dioxide in the presence of sunlight and chlorophyll. The first raw material is water and mineral. Plants get water and minerals which is absorbed by the roots from the soil, and roots has root hairs which helps in increasing the surface area of absorption. And when water and mineral is absorbed by the root, it is transported to different parts of the plant by a network of tube known as xylem. In this way, water and minerals absorbed by soil through roots and transported by
xylems to leaves. The next one is carbon dioxide. And carbon dioxide, which is present in our atmosphere, and it is entered in the in leaf through the tiny pores present on the surface of leaves, which are known as stomata. And stomata are guarded by cells which are known as guard cells. That means exchange of gases takes place through the tiny pores present on the surface of leaf known as stomata.
The next required thing is sunlight, and plants absorb the sunlight from sun due to the presence of chlorophyll in their leaves. Chlorophyll is a green pigment present in the leaves of plant, which has the capacity to trap the sunlight, and with the help of all these plants prepare their food. Now students, one more thing. Photosynthesis is known as a unique process, because by this process food is provided to all living organisms directly or indirectly, and the product oxygen, which is released after the formation of food, that is also necessary for all living organisms in their respiration. That's why photosynthesis is known as a unique process. One more thing, sunlight is the ultimate source of energy. Why? Because all the living organisms which cannot prepare their food, they depend upon plants for their food. That means herbivores depend upon plants directly. And if herbivores are not there, carnivores which depend upon herbivores, they would die. And plants prepare their food in the presence of sunlight. That means if sunlight is not there, plants cannot prepare their food. So we can say that sunlight is the ultimate source of energy. Now the next topic is product of photosynthesis. As you studied that carbohydrate, that is glucose, is formed during the process of photosynthesis. That carbohydrate, which is made up of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen, further converted into starch and stored in different parts of the plant. And protein is also synthesized in the plants. Proteins has carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and nitrogen also. So for the preparation of plants, preparation of proteins, plants require nitrogen also. Nitrogen is present in the atmosphere and that cannot be absorbed by plants directly. So there are some bacteria which present in soil. They convert the nitrogen into usable form and plant absorb the nitrogen with water and other minerals, and that nitrogen is used to form proteins. Oxygen is also the another product of photosynthesis, which is utilized by all the living organisms in the process of respiration. So students, these are the requirement for the process of photosynthesis. That means water, minerals, carbon dioxide, then sunlight and chlorophyll, and how photosynthesis is important for all the living organisms. It is described, you can say that without photosynthesis we cannot imagine life on earth, because photosynthesis is the process by which plants prepare their food, and plants prepare their food and we and other living organisms get their food from plants directly or indirectly. Oxygen is also released by the plants, which is used by all the living organisms. So we can say that without photosynthesis we cannot imagine life on earth. So students, that's all for today. Next topics which are left in the chapter we will discuss in next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.